here on location at the Big Black Box on Murray Street with the awesomeness that is Tree Canal.
Tree Canal, come down.
Yeah,
Wendell Man, Warren, Roger, Robert, Stanton, Killy. Guys, thank you and welcome to the lounge.
Thank you, and welcome
to our home.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you.
So 20 years. Mm-hmm. 20 years. I cannot believe it's been so long since I first saw Blue on TV. And you all just took over, Juve, took over the carnival landscape. 20 years, did you all think that this journey would have lasted this long?
No, we didn't even think it would last a year.
We didn't even realize we was on a journey. We just make the song and we didn't know that this
we,
would
We got choked into recording a song. And I always give Jean-Michel Jibe credit for his persistence and his vision. And the song, as we said in the song, turned the whole world upside down. It literally turned our whole world upside down. So
yes.
we got something that most artists strive for all their life, which is like a massive song right off the bat.
Yeah.
And you know, it's just been trying to keep up with that. Mm-hmm. Because my people tell you Blue is the best song we ever made. So in a sense, you know, we've just been on a journey of exploring and expressing and experimenting.
Yeah.
Giving thanks.
When y'all came out, y'all breathed a fresh breath of life into rap soon. And 20 years later, y'all are still the name that people think about when you think about rap soul. How do you feel about the rap soul movement? Is there a movement?
There is. It's not as cohesive as it was when we first came on board, but it's still there. It's still very much existing. What I say though is that because it's not such a popular form, we have a lot of young artists who are actually doing rap soul, but it's not being called rap soul.
Mm.
And the other day I saw there's something called this new hip hop phenomenon, trap house and whatnot. A lot of those things in another context would be a rap soul vibration.
Right.
But because of the influences of now and whatnot, they're doing more in a Yankee twang. But these fellas, you know, expressing themselves more in a rhythmic form than in a melodic form. So at the core, that is a rap soul.
Yeah.
And then the other component of rap soul is the consciousness of self, which is where Lancelot Bean started.
Yes.
You know, Blue It was about standing firm for who you are and representing yourself. And that's the part that we take strongest from the whole thing.
Y'all have become synonymous with Juve. Mm-hmm. And y'all bring out, since Blue, y'all have been bringing out Juve bands.
Well, we've
been
bringing out Juve bands
before Blue.
Really?
1994 was the first Juve band, it was 3 years before Blue. And
right.
Blue is what catapulted it into the public
Blue was
arena.
Our fourth band.
Yeah. Right, wow. So what is it about Juve that y'all love so much, though?
I think is the most real expression
inside the carnival.
You know, the rest of the thing has become commercialized, so commercial. And in fact, Juve right now is becoming extremely commercialized.
Yes.
The Juve still is very connected to the essence of the whole thing, the Cambule, which is where the whole carnival started.
Yes.
You know, so it's about being connected to that. And it was a conscious decision to remain connected to the Juve because it was the last arena.
And
it was corrupted.
One of the things about the carnival is that we forget that the carnival is a ritual folk festival at its root, at its core. And yeah, there are lots of carnival products that have become commercialized. But in commercializing, we cannot lose sight of what this is inherently. And as Roger was saying, with Cambule, the Cambule riots and all that, the Juve became something else. It's a festival of resistance, a festival of asserting yourself, it's a festival of inversion. So we try to connect to that, and it's in the music. Every year we sing songs just explaining what Juve is to us and hopefully to people around us.
And paying homage to Juve as well.
It's a serious, it's a ritual.
Characters, you know, from the blue to the mud to the dragon to just experimenting the black Indian.
Yes.
You know, all these things, they is a dying culture literally. And the only space it may probably have is for the people who are interested in keeping it alive to bring it in the form of the Juve, because the mass on a Tuesday, nobody going to play in a full black Indian outfit, or nobody's going to play.
Well, the few that play, you know they're old.
They get obliterated.
Contemporary.
And they get obliterated. There's no space for them anymore.
Yes. So over the 20 years, you guys have really helped to bring a lot of new artists to the fore with your backyard jams and that kind of thing. How important has it been for you all to pass on the traditions to the younger artists?
Very, very important, because we benefited from that. We came through the Minchell Mass Camp, we came through, you know, working with the
being
theater workshop, working with, you know, being apprenticed, being mentored and developing, being encouraged, being pushed to do things beyond your school, beyond your own sense of what you're capable of. So when we came into this and we fell in with the Rituals Yard, we were the older fellas in the yard, and we had already had the production experience. Shaf it was who kept saying, let me have you on the jam in the backyard. And eventually we started the Friday night backyards in the Rituals Yard, and it took off. And we realized that, you know, there's that possibility of setting up something where the younger artist who wasn't getting much opportunity to perform would get a chance every Friday to at least to perform and get
hone their skills.
Next thing you know, Denise, Osiwa, Belfort, everybody who had a big tune was following
Denise.
Try out their song on the crowd. So realize that, you know, it's very important to create those spaces for people to develop.
It is.
And I want to stress that word, develop.
Performance is the key now for artists because you're not getting any record sales, there's no music sales anymore.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So performance is the thing that you really need to focus on.
Develop. And I would say that has as a performer. Been the key to our longevity because we haven't always had a huge radio success. We've had songs that have been huge on the radio, but within recent times, you know, our music is out there, we have a strong fan base. But our live performance, I think, is what draws people to us and keeps us going. And, you know, so many youths have passed through our stage, you know, First Class, Second Star, Olatunji, you name it, and they keep coming. And we claim that with pride because we gave them a space when they wanted to flex. Now we have young Sergio.
Right.
You know, he's part of the team. We work with Tall Man Foundation. So working with youths, working with young people is critical to what we do.
It's absolutely essential to breathe new life into the whole thing, you know.
Nice.
And everything what culturally come out of our yard, the pan men and them start in the backyard, who building the mast start in the yard,
and so
by extension the yard is an important thing, you know, having an open air and a tree and a is an important vibe. It's homely.
So tell us about what we can expect for the Three Canal Show in 2017. How are you all going to be celebrating the 20th anniversary?
Well, it's entitled Blue Forever, Forever Blue. Mm-hmm. So starting from where we came from and projecting beyond, you know, as Stanton said, paying homage, paying respects, but also keeping it positive, keeping it upful. You know, the idea of there being a blight or a maljo that we want to cut through, the only way you could cut through that is with light.
Positivity.
Positive vibe. So we're not here to harp and echo, oh God, the place bad,
and
things
preach.
Hard, and preach, you know. So I was setting up the song list the other day, and it's telling a story in and of itself. You know, look, we, good morning, rise, shine, never give up, stronger, try your best, talk your talk.
Good morning is one of my favorites. One of my favorites. It's so natural,
huh?
Good morning
is one of people's favorites.
It's so natural. No, we're supposed to talk to Facebook about good morning there, but...
Yeah, exactly.
So what is the glue that has kept you guys together? You started off as four, you lost a member.
Yeah, respects to John Isaacs. Yeah, always
remember. Somebody talented guy.
Yeah.
Is there any time over the last 20 years that
you
this
up,
unit was in threat of not existing?
A million times. A million gazillion times. It's hard, you know. It's hard to keep the momentum, keep the faith, keep the energy. But somehow we managed to do it time again. Is the work really?
Mm-hmm.
The mission is bigger than us.
I think it's the impact on the people.
Yeah. The people
that is, pushing you back. Makes you say, we have to keep doing this because when people respond in the kind of ways that they do, you bounce them up on the street and they say, wow, this song meant so much to me. My aunt was sick and she was in hospital and she kept listening to her music every day, that kind of thing. Those things really mean a lot and it shows, you know, something is special about this.
And we have a huge support mechanism too. Our team is very big. It's not just three of us, are just the tip of the spear.
Right.
I think it's the work, the context of the work, the content of the work, and how we bring it across and how we always involve people, how we make people feel at home inside our Three Canal.
Right.
How we've taken, you know, people off the street who have never performed before and they're now dancers and they're now singers in their own rights too as well. And we have seen that personal development in them and they have, you know, they feel that level of big brother or father or daddy or some kind of thing towards us, you know, that love. That just keep us going.
Nice. So as we leave, can we get a taste of one of your 2017 releases?
But if you have a bottle and a spoon, I'm going to bring a bottle and a spoon and a drum.
There you go.
Okay, don't worry them now.
Ooh-wah, ooh-wah, ooh-yah-yah-yah-yeah. Ooh-wah, ooh-wah, I go bring a vibe.
Bring a vibes.
Once it's nice, you go recognize, recognize, recognize. But if I tell a lie,
maybe I don't know, you might just play this twice.
Play this twice. We are the kings of the juve. We don't mean to sound haughty. It's the harsh reality. Want to speak out deep down inside away. So I don't need a bottle and a spoon and a drum. I go bring a rhythm and the party go jump. So let me see your hands in the air.
You come prepare.
So everybody here, let me hear you say. Ooh-wah, ooh-wah, ooh-yah-yah-yah-yeah. Ooh-wah, ooh-wah, ooh-yah-yah-yah-yeah. Ooh-wah, ooh-wah, ooh-yah-yah-yah-yeah. Ooh-wah, ooh-wah, ooh-yah-yah-yah-yeah.
What they didn't know, what they didn't know, three canals does make a drain.
Yes.
And we go wash them out again.
Wash them out again.
But they didn't know.
Big respect to Neil Ryan for that one.
I love that song.
And crew.
Wash them out again.